Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, we are going to create a virtual machine directly on our ESXi 01 host. I already have a session open into that host from my infrastructure virtual machine that was created in a previous lab exercise. Host is selected in the navigator pane. I'm going to click on Create Register VM to launch the new virtual machine wizard. We're going to create a new virtual machine. Click Next. Give it a name. We're going to keep the 6.7 hardware compatibility. I'm going to select Linux as the type of guest operating system and CentOS 7 as the version. Click Next. This is going to be stored on Data Store 1, which is our only data store. We're going to stay with one CPU, which is fine. We're going to drop down to 1 gigabyte of memory, change the storage from 16 to 12 gigabytes. I'm going to select thin provisioned. The network adapter is connected to the VM network, which is the only network we have. That's fine. And we have to connect the optical disk to the CentOS ISO that was uploaded onto this host a little earlier. And click this drop down, pick ISO file, click on the ISOs folder, select that ISO that got uploaded, click select. And the one other thing we have to do is make sure that the connected at power on checkbox is selected so that we'll actually be able to boot from the ISO to install the operating system. Click on Next. We can review and make sure that everything here is correct, which it is, and Finish. That will create our virtual machine. If I select Virtual Machines, here's our new VM. If I click on this, then we see the summary information above. And that's it as far as creating the virtual machine is concerned. Now we'll install the guest operating system. I'll power this on. And we'll open a console window so that we can manage this. I'm going to open console in a new tab. And here's my console. I'll arrow up and select install CentOS 7. And then we'll let this go through the installation procedure. I'm going to pause the video and come back when it starts prompting us for input. Okay, we are at the prompt now for some information that we need to provide. We're going to choose English as our language, which is fine. We'll continue from there. And from a localization perspective, the time zone being New York, the Americas is fine for us. We have to specify, or more or less confirm, the destination for storage. That's going to go onto the one and only disk we have, so we'll say done for that. And then we do have to configure the network. So I'm going to go into configure here. We're going to specify for IPv4 that this is going to be manual. I'm going to add an IP configuration. The netmask is going to be 24-bit. Put in the default gateway. And we'll add in a DNS server as well. Which will work fine for what we're doing. This does not have to match the IP address of our infrastructure host. So all we need to do for that, so I'm going to save that out. And we will enable the network. And we'll also set the host name to CentOS 01. Apply that and say we're done with the network configuration. And now we can begin the installation. Need to, of course, configure our root password. And we're going to let this install. I'm going to pause the video at this point in time, and we'll come back once the installation's finished. Okay, the installation is finished. All we have to do is reboot. So we'll do that quickly. And then we also have to disconnect the ISO from the optical disk. I'm going to close the console here because it's not necessary. And on the virtual machine, I can click on edit, which is the same as edit the settings. And that will bring up our hardware config because it's rebooting. That's a tiny bit slow right now. But down here where it says data store ISO file, I will grab that, change this back to the host device, save that, and then we will no longer be attached to the ISO file. That's really important if you have a virtual machine in production and it has to migrate from one host to another. If you're attached to an ISO file that's on a local storage on one of those hosts, it's not going to be able to migrate because it's going to lose that connection. It won't be able to maintain it. And therefore, that migration will fail. Okay, this is rebooted. Basically, we're good to go with that. And the VM is now done. Now, that doesn't mean we're finished yet because we have a little bit of post-install config to do. One of the things we have to do is install VMware Tools, which is the extension in vSphere that allows the hypervisor to talk to the guest operating system. Going to open the console. Again, we'll just do a new tab in the browser. Need to log in once this opens. And the first thing we're going to do is install VMware Tools. This is much easier than on Windows because this is something that's actually in a Yum repository or an app repository if you're working on Ubuntu, for example. So just let that go out and grab the information from our nearest mirror. And that will install in a second. There we go. The other thing we're going to need for labs down the road is Perl. So we're going to install Perl as well while we're at it. All right. So that's got that software installed on our virtual machine. The last thing we have to do to make this virtual machine ready for our lab is upload a file to the VM. Let me shrink down my browser window, and we're going to copy the file up using WinSCP since we're connecting in the Linux. Notice on my desktop, I've got this file called CPUBusy, which is a Perl script. That is on your core shell, so you're going to need to, from your VM, connect into the learning management system and then download that file from the core shell so that you have it. Once you've done that, we're going to launch WinSCP. And when that opens, we're going to connect into our virtual machine that is running on the ESXi 1 host. Okay, so we'll put in the IP on that virtual machine. Username will be root, and then we'll be using the course password to connect in. And we will accept the self-signed certificate. Okay, over on the left, right now this is in my documents. I want to go to the desktop. Here's that file. And this needs to be installed in the root user directory, which this is in by default. I'm just going to grab this file and pull it over here and say, yes, I want to copy that. And while we're here, to make this a little bit easier, because we're going to have to change the permissions to allow that to run as a script, I'm simply going to select the execute bit to change the permission. You can always go into the VM and change the permission that way if you want, but we're already here, so we might as well change it while we're at it. And that's all we need to do for that, so we can close the session out and close down WinSCP. And now, if I pull my browser back up, I can actually do a quick listing here. And here is that CPUBusy Perl script that has been copied up. So we're basically finished with this. I can log out of Linux. I can close down my console window, which is no longer required. And my virtual machine is now completely ready to be used for future labs. That's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.